Yesterday was the 53rd running of the Great American Race, the Daytona 500. And while it started out somber as the 10th anniversary of the death of a beloved icon, the rest of the day belonged to a young man in a big hurry, the youngest man ever to win the big one.
In winning the 2011 Daytona 500, Trevor Bayne stormed onto the front page of the racing world, becoming the youngest winner of the sport's biggest event and celebrating on its grandest stage.
There's nothing like winning a Daytona 500. I don't know if I'll ever experience anything like that again. Hopefully we'll win another one and win some championships.
In the process, the 20-year-old up-and-comer pulled off one of the biggest upsets in sports history, vaulting himself into the national spotlight and establishing himself as the face of the new generation of professional athletes. Literally overnight, the Knoxville, Tennessee native became a household name and social media sensation. However, lofty achievements don't come without a price, and fame without sacrifice. For Bayne, that sacrifice comes in the form of long hours in the gym.
There's two reasons to be physically fit in racing. One is because you'll be worn out if you're not. It is really physically demanding in a race car. It's 140, 150 degrees at times, depending on how hot it is that weekend. It's like sitting in a sauna and taking on some G-forces for 4 hours at a time. Outside of that, there's not much we can do as drivers during the week to better ourselves in the car. We can't go practice, we can't go test, can't go out here in the parking lot and make laps. The only thing that we can do to make ourselves better in that race car is be physically fit.
For Bayne, the commitment to stay physically fit is more than an initiative, it's a way of life. And in the end, provides the edge that sets champions apart from the rest of the field.
If it's something you've prepared for and you've worked at, it fuels the fire to go after it. On that restart of Texas when I was sitting fourth and it had been 2 years in the making waiting on that first nationwide win, it wasn't like I just showed up that day and hopped in a race car for the first time and now I'm fourth, okay, I might go win this race. It was something that we wanted and we had been working at it, and there's points in a race where you can make a difference as a driver and say, you know, okay, I've got a fifth place car, I'm going to finish fifth, or you can say, I've got a fifth place car and I'm going to go try to win this race, and you got to dig down deep and go after them.
Celebrating 25 winning years, this is Roush Fenway Racing.